is Ferenc Borondics, and I'm the responsible for the SMIS spectrum microscopy beamline in the Soleil synchrotron. SMIS is an infrared spectrum microscopy beamline, and this means that we use the infrared light generated by the Soleil storage ring to study the properties of materials. We look at molecular vibrations, crystal vibrations, low energy electronic excitations to learn about the properties of samples. This allows us to really address problems from the cultural heritage all the way to the biomedical fields. The reason that we use a synchrotron for spectrum microscope measurements in the infrared is that the source quality allows us to focus the beam to a diffraction limited spot. So basically the source is very special for us. The instruments are usually commercial instruments, but combining the commercial instruments and the synchrotron source, we can really achieve a quality of spectrum microscopy that is impossible to do elsewhere. Alternative sources like the infrared lasers or the thermal sources, they also allow you to do spectrum microscopy measurements in the infrared. But on one hand, the synchrotron allows the very high spatial resolution and the very broad band. So this combination really is unique, and therefore we build infrared beamlines. We can focus the synchrotron beam to the diffraction limit, which allows us to really measure at the few micron resolution. And you can see some of these instruments behind me. But this diffraction limited spot can also be directed towards other type of instruments that allow us to work in the near field, and therefore we can measure all the way to 20 nanometer resolution. And so with 10 micron light, we are able to measure 20 nanometer spots. We have three scientists working at the SMIS beamline, including myself. Each one of us have a specific area that we specialize to. My specialty is in the material sciences. And we have one colleague who is a high pressure physicist, Francesco Capitani, and another one who is a biospectroscopist. His name is Christoph Sand.
I'm Christoph Sand. I am a beamline scientist at the SMIS beamline. I'm particularly in charge of biospectroscopy using infrared microscope to study biological samples. So there's two types of samples that we mainly use. It can be 2D cell cultures or it could be tissue sections. We are able to extract quite a wealth of information from these biological samples. So the first thing that infrared microspectroscopy can do is to look at the chemical composition of your tissue and extract quantitative information about the concentration of some specific molecules like carbohydrates or lipids. Another way to look at tissues will be to search for specific biomarkers. Infrared spectroscopy can identify molecules by their specific molecular fingerprint, which allows us to identify specific molecules. For example, we can find the presence of specific microcrystals in kidney, or we can find creatine in the brain of animals with epileptic seizure. And so we can use this fingerprinting ability to get biomedical information, diagnostic, or purely analytical information. A third way to use infrared microspectroscopy will be to look at the conformation of molecules. Infrared is very specific, but it can give you conformation information, so we can look at the conformation as a biomarker. For example, when we diagnose the presence of amyloid fibrils in the brain of Alzheimer's disease patients. The last way we can use infrared microspectroscopy in biospectroscopy, in biomedical diagnosis, is to look at the fingerprint of tissues or cells. Each type of tissue, each type of cell might have a very specific spectral signature, and we are able to recognize that, and we can use that as a diagnostic. We can compare cells which are from different origin, and we can assess and recognize their origin from a specific tissue or a specific phenotype.
Another activity of the SMIS beamline is the study of materials at very high pressure, where very high pressure means thousands or millions of atmosphere. So we're able in the laboratory to generate pressures which are of the same order of magnitude of what we have inside, for example, our planets. And this is possible thanks to the diamond anvil cell, which is a device where we have two opposite diamond anvil and we squeeze the sample in between these diamond anvils. The nice thing of diamond anvil cell is that diamonds are transparent to the infrared. And so it's very interesting to couple infrared spectroscopy with diamond anvil cell and high pressure. And the sample inside this diamond anvil is very small. So this is why we need a very brilliant source as the synchrotron radiation. And also then we need a microscope that we can see here, because we need to focus down the light into this very small sample inside the Darmon-Anvil cell. And the sample is typically tens or hundreds of micron. With pressure and with infrared spectroscopy, we can then investigate what happens to materials at these very high pressures. So typically we can have phase transformation, a liquid that becomes solid, for example, or also electronic phase transition as from an insulator to metals. Then we could also couple, for example, another thermodynamic variable, which is temperature, with pressure. For that, we need other equipment that we can install in this setup, because we designed custom-made objectives that allows a very large working distance. So we can fit in this setup Darmon-Anvil cells, but also furnaces for high temperature and cryostats for low temperatures. And this allows us, for example, to mimic the condition that we have inside the Earth mantle. So this is for geology or geophysical interest. So we can check at high pressure and high temperature what happens to mineral, what are the chemical reactions occurring. Or if we go to low temperature instead and high pressure, this is more of interest for physical phenomena, in particular quantum phenomena at very low temperature in advanced materials such as superconductivity or other exotic phenomena. So we can retrieve structural, chemical, but also electronic information from all kinds of samples, from all kinds of fields.
Besides using the synchrotron source, we also have instruments that work offline with the non-synchrotron sources, for example, lasers and internal thermal sources. What you see next to me is also a subdiffraction limit technique where we can measure spatial resolution around 500 nanometers. We also have imaging microscopes that can measure really large samples, and we collaborate with colleagues from Ecole Polytechnique on spectroscopic infrared polarimetry.